David Ciclatera is back with me this morning from Live Company. David, morning.
Good morning.
Another significant deal here, this licensing and merchandising agreement with LMI. David, tell me more about who they are.
LMI is a British agency that has been around for some time, best known because when Star Wars back in the day started, they were a young company and they developed the Star Wars merchandising. The most recent activity is they're the people behind it, certainly in Europe, Game of Thrones. So they've been extremely busy over the last year or two. I've known the people a long time. They've been very keen to do something with BritLive, and I felt we had to get to a certain size before we did that. This, of course, is a new revenue stream for us, and it's something that, to be honest, we have in our 2020 numbers, not in 2019. The reason to do it now is the biggest licensing show in the world is Las Vegas at the beginning of June, and everybody was keen that we got BritLive. Now we're in America, out there, so it's a deal that is in advance of what we expected to do, and I think it's important that we've done this deal now.
And as you say, they've worked with the likes of Star Wars, Game of Thrones, so the fact they've identified BritLive, Live Company, as a firm to work with, that's a strong endorsement of yourselves.
Yeah, I think so, and I think the most interesting thing is it reinforces the fact that we own our own IP. So here we are, BritLive is our own IP. Of course, we're talking about our own merchandising, and we're talking about them obviously finding licensing partners. They're well structured. They have partner companies throughout the world, from Japan to USA to South America. So all of the people that they know will be able to work with our local partners as well. So it's a very good fit. But I think if you think we're close to, by the end of this year, I think we'll have, you know, on an annual basis, 1 million people coming to see our shows. Right now, there is little or none, no merchandising to buy. That's something that particularly the zoo program has been asking us for. We're developing the designs right now. They will be out in the market by the autumn. And obviously, that's something that LMI can work with.
What kind of merchandise might we be talking about?
Well, for the shows, it's relatively basic. It's T-shirts, hats, magnets, pins, and that's the sort of thing that when I was in America at the Dallas show, we had a few pieces of merchandising, and they went so quickly. And Americans, particularly if the audience go to America, have anything to do with American sport, for example, they have huge amounts of merchandising. They sell huge amounts of merchandising. And I think this is something that we're a fast-growing company who've only been here, as you know, since December 2017. It's the same as the true of the sponsorship revenues. I took the decision that until we got our network, until we got everything up and running, we couldn't really develop these ancillary lines of revenue. We've now done that, and I think there's a strong request for merchandising. So I'm pleased that we made this announcement today.
Well, by the sounds of it, if what you're saying, you're getting close to 1 million people turning up to some of these shows, it could be quite a significant revenue stream, this.
Well, if you think of it, it's not an unreasonable thing to think on average that someone would spend £10 with you. And it's when you have families come, they always want to buy something for their children. I mean, you only have to look at some of the numbers, the retail partners. So I go back to one of our early shows when £1 million of Lego boxes were sold during the 4-day show. So potentially this is a significant revenue earner for us. But it's also, it's one of those kind of virtual things, because we have our brand. People go out and buy things with your brand on. It enhances the brand value. I continually go on when we sit and talk together about how important it is for this group to own its own IP. People pay fortunes for IPs. They're buying IPs. We think it's very important, but the value, this will enhance the value of when some third party looks at our value for our IP, this will help, I think, in that process.
You've talked a lot about Europe and America, but in Asia too, a strong appeal for merchandise.
Yes, but I think the key areas will be Europe and America. merchandising is particularly strong in America, and I think Asia, of course, it'll work in Asia. But I think as we've, I think we were on talking about a week ago, we developed a new show in Brussels. Mm. We have further conversations going on in Europe. It's strange in this time of Brexit, etc., but we've never been so busy in Europe. And I think that Europe is a strong economy. There is a strong middle class, strong supporters for education. So anyway, I'm very, very happy to be here today. I've known the guys at LMI for nearly 25 years, so I know what they can do. They're one of those companies that slowly gets on with it, and it's kind of, you're making money while you sleep.
And just remind me then, how soon are you looking to have some of this merchandise available at
these
shows?
It'll be out by Q4.
Right.
So.
And while I've got you, David, not too far away from the results, early June, we're expecting those?
Yes, early June. First week of June.
And along with that, the broker note too, which we've talked
Absolutely.
About in the past.
And we've put a lot of effort in this year to make sure the accounts are informative as possible, because we get lots of questions from our stakeholders about numbers of shows, whether Asia is more important than America, etc., etc. So we've spent time whilst with the auditors have been counting bricks, because I have to say that's been. The reason that things have taken slightly longer is getting their heads around 100 million bricks was quite an interesting process. Fortunately, I can say that we do have 100 million bricks, but that's the real reason that things have been slightly delayed.
Good to see you, David. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much.